Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are the news making headlines for Filipinos in North America.
Mabuhay. I, Richie Valdez, do swear.
With these words, an emotional member of parliament, Richie Valdez, ended a decades-long drought of Filipino representation in Canada's cabinet. Valdez, the first Filipina elected to the House of Commons, representing the riding of Streetsville, Mississauga in Ontario, was promoted by Prime Minister Justin Trudeau to the post of Minister of Small Business.
I, Richie Valdez, do solemnly and sincerely promise and swear that I will truly and faithfully and to do the best of my skill and knowledge execute the powers and trust repose in me as Minister Small Business. So help me God.
Valdez is among the seven rookie MPs that Trudeau appointed in his cabinet reshuffle. She said she's grateful for her appointment, which will give a voice to Filipino Canadians in Ottawa.
It means a lot to both for Filipino representation across the country. We are 1 million strong. And so just ensuring that they have their voice.
I dream the dream in time gone by.
In other news, 9-year-old singer Estela Celeste headlines the Philippines program this Saturday before the country unveils its dazzling entry to the fireworks display competition at the Celebration of Light in Vancouver. Estela, who will be doing a 30-minute set, has been practicing hard for this event.
I'm going to be entertaining the crowd. I'm going to sing lots of songs for them, like Dream On, His Eyes on the Sparrow, and many more.
Estela has been a featured performer in many Filipino events. She recently got the highest average mark in the vocal competition of the BC Conservatory of Music.
I like to sing because it makes people happy.
And finally, we head to California, where superheroes crash landed into San Diego for 5 days to celebrate the annual Comic-Con International Convention. Filipino fans flocked in costume as creators showcased their art and shared their insights on the comic book world. Among the high-profile Filipinos appearing at the hundreds of panel discussions, Marvel's Anthony Francisco, who shared his fight for diversity in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, explaining how he added Pinoy flair to movies such as Black Panther and Guardians of the Galaxy.
With me, I try to put as much of my culture as I can into my designs. For example, when I designed the Dorma Lodge, aside from being all African, I had 10% Filipino, 5% Samurai. And for Baby Groot, I would add the Bonito tree is like a Filipino tree that I would want to grow up with. And I joke that Baby Groot's Filipino, but he's not an alien.
Plenty of history out there, and also very inspiring for future generations to kind of go ahead and blaze onto that path.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC news on the ABS-CBN News website and YouTube channel. Back to you guys at the rundown.
Lawyers of former U.S. President Donald Trump meet with Justice Department officials investigating his efforts to overturn his 2020 election defeat. On his Truth Social platform, Trump said the meeting was productive, adding his lawyers were not informed of when action was likely. Earlier this month, Trump revealed he had received a letter from Special Counsel Jack Smith that he was a target of the probe. Officials have testified that during his final months in office, Trump pressured them with false claims of widespread voter fraud. His supporters attacked the U.S. Capitol on January 6, 2021, in a bid to stop Congress from certifying Joe Biden's win. It is not uncommon for defense attorneys to meet with federal prosecutors before an indictment. The White House rules out the possibility that U.S. President Joe Biden would pardon his son, Hunter. The younger Biden is facing charges of failing to pay taxes on more than $1.5 million in income in 2017 and 2018. Hunter's deal with prosecutors to plead guilty to these tax charges and avoid a gun charge collapsed on Wednesday, but the judge said more time was needed to review their agreement. The CAF and allies of former President Donald Trump had criticized the deal, saying it unfairly favors Biden's son. Ukraine has recaptured the southeastern village of Istaramayorska from Russian forces. That's according to Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky. Now, the village lies to the south of the cluster of small settlements that Ukraine reclaimed during a counteroffensive, which began early in June. Russian troops hold swathes of northern and eastern Ukraine. And Zelensky touts what he called as very good results from Kyiv's forces, but he also acknowledged slow progress in their counteroffensive.